coming back here to Pomona. You've had a lot of championship winning performances here over the years. Just what is it about this place that has suited you and just your team, no matter what year it is?
You know, some racetracks show you a lot of love, and this happens to be one of them. You know, what's really special about this racetrack is, like, the champions are crowned here, right? You know, it has so much history. You know, a lot of times we used to start here, finish here, and you know, you got to witness over the last 20 years of my career different champions being crowned, and to be a part of that, and to be, you know, to have four championships that's been crowned here with, you know, for us, it's got a special place in my heart. You know, and I'm really glad that Pomona does show us a lot of love, because there's a lot of times where, you know, it all comes down to this last race, and, you know, you go to the second, third round a lot of times. So, you know, I there's a track in Sonoma that I haven't, that's the only one on the season that I haven't won at, and I'm sure glad that this is not it, you know what I mean? Because in the countdown, it all kind of counts and all matters, but we're still fortunate to be in the hunt every year of my career that we've been out here, except for, I think, 2012 is the only year that I wasn't really in a championship contention. And that just says a lot about my guys. It says a lot about my crew chiefs, you know, all the guys that you surround yourself with. And I think that's the biggest thing, is that we have an amazing group of sponsors with Dodge and Direct Connection and all the SRT stuff and that we do. But between our great sponsors, we've assembled a great unit of a group of individuals that work really hard. They're driven, they're motivated, they get up early, they leave late, they stay at the track. I'm eating steak dinner a lot of times, and those guys are still bouncing tires and stuff. And so I'd love to sit here and pat myself on the back and say, you know, I'm this great driver, and I've had four championships and runners-up and 52 wins and all these world records and stuff. But truly, truly, it's because the group of people that we've surrounded ourselves with the sponsors, with Dodge and Johnson Horsepower Garage and Motor Mile and you know, American Rebel Beer and all the folks. It takes a village to do what we do, on top of a pile of money, right? So I think it's such a humbling sport, because it's such a team sport, you know, and that's something that I've had to learn, and I think Tony's learning it right now, you know, race by race, is that you don't have a lot of control over the outcome. You know, you have to, everyone has to do their part, and there's so many ways for it to go wrong. And so when you do turn four win lights on Sunday, you've done something super special, and that's just a race win. We're not talking about a championship, you know what I mean? So when you get to that next level with trying to compete for a championship, with the pressure and the motivation and all the stuff that has to come together, it becomes pretty special.
And obviously this year you had another great year, but Frock's in another stratosphere, of course. Yeah. But for you, what do you feel, how would you assess the year overall, and what you guys have had done positively?
Yeah, very growing year for us. We've had a lot of internal things that are going on that I can't really speak on, but we've had a lot of growth in a lot of different directions. And I think it sums it up for me. The other day I saw something on the internet, and they're interviewing this guy, and he won a championship a couple years ago as a basketball player. And he basically said, well, this year, you know, you guys didn't hardly win any, you guys didn't, you know, win any basketball games, and it was a really off year. And the guy was going, like, you know, how do you feel about your failure as a season? And the guy looked at the reporter and was like, hey, man, you know, Michael Jordan won, I don't know, was 6-8 championships, you know, out of 15, 16 years that he was there. He said, do you really feel like those years that he didn't win championships were a failure? Said, no, it's a growing year. You know, you grow from it internally. You do all those things to grow. So even though we've only won 3 races this year, and we're probably going to end up not winning the championship, we still have grown a lot. We have learned a lot from that. So I think you break it down in every year, and you learn something from it. You grow. And I grow every time I get in a car. It costs $7,000 to make one pull if it doesn't hurt anything. That's if it's not on fire, that's not if the body doesn't blow off of it. That's just going down the racetrack, it's $7,000. So every time I make a run in that car, I process that information. I'm coming back, I'm playing it through my head. What did it do? How did I learn from it? How do I grow from it? And that's what you have to do with your seasons as well.
Yeah, obviously this year is a pretty monumental year with hitting 50 career wins, Funny Car. And looking back at that time in Charlotte, what do you feel you still look back on this, you know, just memories in general?
Yeah, you know, I mean, to be blessed to have won over 50 races in what is one of the, I feel like, the most competitive classes out there. I mean, it's right up there with pro stock, as being like, we're running 330 miles an hour, and these guys were winning races by, you know, fractions of a second, you know, it blows my mind, right? Like these crew chiefs can, they take, there's only three manufacturers out here. They take all the parts and pieces and they all dump them in a pile and everybody picks from this different deal and you get them to run so close. It really, to be able to win that many races and to have a group around me like that is just a very blessed individual, man. And I think that, you know, my guys are everything. They're very important to me. I've had plenty of opportunities for our guys to go other places and do different things. And it's been very, very important to me as we keep our group together as a unit and we work hard together and in one common goal. But yeah, 50 some races, it blows my mind, you know, because I was looking at my wall the other day and all these trophies stacked up there with all these championship trophies and stuff. And you were going like, damn, I didn't know I was going to be good at it. You know what I mean? It's just kind of something that happened, you know what I mean? So never really set out to be a professional race car driver. It's just something that evolved into what it was. And then just having such a good group around me, we were just super successful.
Final question, just, you know, going into the off season, obviously I'm sure there's a lot of points that you guys can look at and assess and everything else. Just for you, what are some of the things you guys are looking at and making sure that you're ready to go and take it to Proc or anyone?
We absolutely got outworked this year. You know what I mean? We won the championship last year, and and I'll say it as much as anybody. We rested on our laurels. You know what I mean? We you know, the rules are so tough that it's hard to do a whole lot of innovation just because you're not allowed to touch much of this stuff. But at the end of the day, you have to tip your cap to Proc and those guys over there. They found some stuff that we obviously don't have, and same with the other teams. Like, they've won 8 races. They've been 14 number one qualifiers. You know, and so you have to go, like, hey, man, y'all worked a little harder than we did. So I think it's definitely a momentum boost to say, hey, we got to get back to the grindstone. What we got is not going to cut it. We have to work behind the scenes. You know, what's really cool about having Tony Stewart as a boss is that he okays all that. You know what I mean? He's like, whatever it takes to win. That's why we were testing Monday in Vegas. We had 2 big blow-ups. Tony blew up, and then I blew up, you know, and it was a really costly weekend for Tony. And so we were kind of like, well, should we test? Should we not? Because every time, like you said, it costs $7,000 to make a run. And Tony was like, absolutely test. He's like, whatever it takes to go faster, he's like, that's what we're here for. That's what we're going to do. And to have a boss like that that is driven and motivated, that has a desire to win, that is a competitor himself, it's just nice. You know what I mean? So I wouldn't say money is not an option. It's just, if it's devoted and used towards the right resources and to improve and to go faster, he's always on board. And so that means a lot to me. That means that I know that over the off season, anything that these guys want to do as far as getting back to the grinding stone and figuring out how we can go faster and what we can do and how we can massage on our stuff, we're going to do, because we obviously didn't get it done this year. It's great to be in the hunt and have a chance to do it, but that still ain't getting it done. You know what I mean? So, you know, I know that we're going to, you know, go back and work hard, and I believe in my guys, and I believe in the parts and pieces and all the stuff that Dodge does for us, and, you know, we just got to go back and work harder.